Welcome to another video tutorial. In this video, we will be talking about how to write discussion section of an article. Usually we know that discussion writing is a little tricky and needs knowledge than as compared, because students have already done their experiments, so they know how to write results, but mostly the discussion parts remains tricky for them. So here is helpful comments which we can consider while writing. The first one, we can see that why we write discussion. So usually we write discussion in order to explain our own findings. So you can simply say that this is the section which is essentially written to explain your findings. So in the second point, we can see that in very simple terms, you can and answer the all questions which you were supposed and you which you have started with your experiments as hypothesis. I mean that why you did that way. So it means you need to answer important question in your experiments and you need to discuss them in the discussion part. And the third important point which we should consider, that it explains the result of your studies and it just connects the ideas, different ideas of your experiment and discussion, and it connects a bridge between the your questions and answers which you have started at the hypothesis. So here in order to our own understanding, I have developed and chosen four approaches to write discussion section. So in the first part, we can see that the first one is explain your finding. So when you are going to explain your results, you can just write and start to explain your results in the first paragraph, and in the second paragraph you can compare them. So I mean, and the second part would be the evaluation of the first two part. Like in the first part, what we will do, I will explain later on. After the evaluation, we can go to the fourth and important part, that is infer from the finding. So here I can show you the first approach. We can see that in the first approach, usually we need to explain your findings. So I mean, what you have just started, you need to just give reason or explanation that why you did this experiment. You also need to start to tell the scenario and the different conditions during the data collection and the result studies. You can all explain those conditions. So that would be your first part. And while moving to the second part and the second approach, that is compare to the findings. I mean, what you have got results, you will explain in the first headings, and in the second heading, you will just compare them with other, like you need to compare the findings of research with other findings of the same published field literature. So we can say that you need to compare the relevant and the different findings, and you can compare them finally. So in simple words, we can say that you can just compare your own results with the other scientists which they have published the similar results. You can tell them how our results are different, or how your material is different, or how your studies and statistical methods you applied are different. So after in the first step we have just explained, and the second step we are going to compare them. After their comparison, we need to evaluate them, that what you get as results, how it is meaningful. You can say them that either it is positive or negative. So you can provide an assessment of findings, like as we did. We can just recall our ideas in the first step, we have just explained the ideas. In the second step, we have just compared them. Now we need to evaluate them, that how, what was our results. I mean, because in the first step we will just give the number and statistical form, and the second step we just made a comparison how it is different. So now we are going to give a final statement about our results, that either decide if our results are positively significant or negatively significant. So in the other words, you can call them that we are evaluating our findings. And in the third and the fourth important approach is the inferation from the findings. So you can infer some meanings and some conclusions from your results, like you can develop your own point of views and ideas based on the facts and results. So, and you can make sense of them. And an important thing, do not leave findings in the statistical form here, because you can only give the statistical form of data in the first two steps. And thus, in the second line, you need to provide the statistical data. And we also don't need to be afraid by giving and predicting some conclusions. So we can predict here, we can give, like, if we get this result, what we can conclude further, what we can conclude indirectly, what it's mean. So you can just predict here. You can relate your research with other findings, like if you have obtained this data, so what it can be related to other data, how it can give answers to the other questions. So this is important part. So if you want to write your results, you just need to divide your all main results into small main headings. Like in your result section, you have six parts. And let's suppose in each of two parts, you have explained one idea. So let's suppose in the result section, you have given six headings. So you can make three small headings in discussion section. And you can explain each heading according to the approach, like you need to apply approach 1, 2, 3, and 4. In this way, you can write your results easily. Hope so you have liked the video. If you have any further comment, please tell me in the comments. I will try my best to answer your question. That's all. Thank you for watching. Bye bye.